I am Matthew Levine, a transplant surgeon and immunologist in the Perelman School of Medicine at the University of Pennsylvania, and I'm here with David Aufhauser, a surgical resident and research fellow in my laboratory. We'd like to highlight our work on sexual dimorphism and kidney ischemic injury from our recently published research article in the Journal of Clinical Investigation. The impetus to study this subject in depth came from a known observation that there is significant gender discrepancy in murine renal ischemia models, and there had been prior work done by other groups indicating that testosterone has a negative impact on ischemia tolerance. We wish to further delineate the underlying biology of this dimorphism with an eye on potential translational application to improve renal ischemia tolerance. There are four fundamental questions that we wish to answer. One, are the sex effects on ischemia reperfusion injury tolerance mediated by intrinsic differences in the kidney itself, by host responses to ischemia, or both? Two, is the relative resistance to ischemic injury seen in female mice due to protective effects of the female hormonal environment due to a lack of the previously identified negative impact of the male hormonal environment, or a combination of the two? Three, can the tolerance of ischemia reperfusion injury, or IRI, be modulated by alteration in hormonal background? And four, can we identify clear evidence of similar gender dimorphism in human IRI as evidenced by investigation of clinical renal transplant delayed graft function, or DGF? The basic science aspects of this work were largely performed by David Aufhauser and Zhonglin Wang in my laboratory and will be described by David.
With these aims, we developed a murine model of unilateral renal injury consisting of laparotomy, microvascular clamp of the renal pedicle, and contralateral nephrectomy. In this model, serum biochemistries reflect solely the function of the injured kidney. Significant attention must be paid to strict core body temperature control to attain reproducible results using this system, and we developed a specific apparatus for this purpose. Using this model, we established 28 minutes of warm IRI as a maximal sublethal insult in B6 female mice. Males subjected to the same 28-minute period of IRI universally died of renal failure within 48 hours of the injury. However, males subjected to 15 minutes of warm IRI exhibited equivalent biochemical injury and fibrosis 28 days later as females subjected to 28 minutes of IRI. This reflects an almost twofold increased tolerance of warm IRI duration in females. To define the role of sex hormones in this process, we neutered male and female mice at 2 weeks, let them develop to maturity, and then tested their IRI tolerance. Neutered mice of either gender tolerated a 28-minute IRI without lethality and displayed an intermediate phenotype that had significantly worsened renal function compared to hormonally intact females. This suggests that hormones mediate these gender differences. To further investigate the mutability of these gender effects, we performed a series of kidney transplants between mice of different genders with minimal cold ischemia time and subjected the kidneys to warm ischemia after they recovered from the transplant. We assured that the transplanted kidney function returned to normal prior to the warm IRI experiment. In this model, kidneys displayed differential IRI tolerance based on the new host gender, with female recipients displaying significantly improved biochemical function and later development of fibrosis compared to males. In transplant experiments performed with prolonged cold ischemia, we again saw differential gender effects, with the donor gender largely dictating the degree of renal injury. These experiments demonstrated that even kidneys that had developed to adulthood in one hormonal environment could take on the ischemia tolerance of the other hormonal environment after transplantation, meaning that the differential IRI tolerance was not intrinsic to the kidney. We next investigated whether the superior tolerance of IRI observed in female mice could be replicated or enhanced with exogenous estrogen administration. We found that supplemental estrogen administered before renal IRI resulted in significant renal protection in females and in neutered males, but not in hormonally intact males. We saw lesser effects that were not significant when estrogen was given at the time of ischemia. To begin to delineate the mechanism behind these findings, we tested the effect of estrogen receptor alpha knockout on the female tolerance of IRI. These mice were generously provided on the appropriate B6 background in collaboration by Jose Janeiro Garcia and Nicolas Cervernos of the Wistar Institute. Estrogen receptor alpha knockout mice had significantly impaired renal recovery compared to wild-type B6 mice and displayed a similar phenotype to intact male mice, with universal death of renal failure following a 28-minute warm ischemic injury. Tolerance of warm IRI in this group of estrogen receptor knockout mice was worse than that seen in neutered female mice.
We then wished to determine whether similar gender dimorphism could be identified in human renal IRI, and to do so, we analyzed a database provided by UNOS OPTN encompassing national renal transplant data in the United States from 1997 to 2011. We investigated whether there were gender associations with delayed graft function, or DGF, the result of IRI, sufficient to require post-transplant dialysis within the first week after renal transplantation. Prior studies had investigated gender effects on long-term kidney transplant survival, but to our knowledge, no studies had focused on short-term IRI outcomes like DGF. Our analysis included only adult kidney recipients of deceased donor transplants who were on dialysis at the time of transplant because of difficulty defining DGF in patients not yet requiring renal replacement therapy at the time of transplant. In our logistic regression analysis, we found a strong correlation between male recipient gender and DGF, with an odds ratio of 1.36. This magnitude of the association with DGF was larger than that seen with recipient diabetes or highly sensitized recipients, and was of similar magnitude to the utilization of extended criteria kidneys, advanced age, and cold ischemia time between 17 and 24 hours. The size of the association was smaller than that of utilization of kidneys from donors after cardiac death or with prolonged cold ischemia times of greater than 24 hours. Male donors also had a significantly increased association with DGF, but the effect size was small. Because prior studies on influences of gender on long-term kidney transplant outcomes had attributed these differences to size discrepancy between the genders and nephron dosing effects, we sought to separate these effects from gender effects by dividing kidney transplants from the UNOS database into deciles based on degree of donor to recipient size mismatch, and then we reanalyzed the data for association between size mismatch and gender and DGF. Both extremes of size mismatch were associated with DGF, as you can see in the bars displayed, but in all but one decile, this association was smaller than that of male recipient gender. This result indicated that extremes of size mismatch are impactful, but that the female recipient gender is associated with lower DGF rates across all size mismatch deciles. If we isolated the study population to postmenopausal age patients, we see a decrease in the odds ratio of DGF in male recipients from 1.36 to 1.26, suggesting that effects diminish either with loss of hormonal environment or with age. A subgroup analysis limited to deceased donors who donated one kidney to a female recipient and one kidney to a male recipient allows us to fix all donor effects to be equivalent between the groups except for ischemia time and size mismatch, which were included in the multivariable analysis. This subgroup analysis actually yielded an increased odds ratio for DGF among male recipients to 1.43. The summation of this work does allow us to address the main questions that inspired us to perform this study. Differential tolerance of renal IRI in mice is extrinsic to the kidney and mutable with transplantation into a different sex host or with hormonal manipulation. The female environment appears to be protective and the male environment sensitizing to renal IRI in mice. While prior groups see a detrimental impact of testosterone on renal IRI in experimental systems, we here see beneficial effects of supplemental administration of estrogen to female mice just prior to IRI. Lastly, we see a strong correlation with female recipient gender and absence of delayed graft function in large numbers of human renal transplant events. This effect is not explained by donor and recipient size discrepancy. These findings, taken together, encourage attempts at translational investigation of estrogens in larger animal models or human scenarios of predictable renal IRI, such as transplantation or cardiac bypass. We would like to thank our strong and ongoing collaborators in the laboratory of Wayne Hancock at the Children's Hospital of Philadelphia. Zhongling Wang performed the complex murine renal transplant experiments highlighted above. Yanfeng Wang, now of the Wuhan University, set the stage for this work and performed some of the preliminary studies at Penn. We would like to thank the NIH, NIDDK, and HRSA for support of the efforts of the investigators of this study. We would also like to thank the Penn Department of Surgery, the Penn Transplant Institute, and the Penn Institute for Immunology for generous funding of our work.